Sean.
Hi, Joel. How are you?
Good, thanks.
Tell me a little bit about your operation here. What do you grow? How many acres of it?
Okay, we grow about 700 to 800 acres of vegetables, and then we grow another 1,200 or so of cash crop.
Yep.
We grow, this year we're going to have 250 acres of carrots. We're going to have about 140-ish acres of celery, 100 acres of potatoes. I grow some onions as well, and then I follow that up, as I said, with corn, soybeans, wheat, growing a bit of canola this year as well. We don't have a whole lot of options for herbicides, so we have to try and keep it rotating so we don't treat resistance problems.
Okay, so what challenges do you have today as far as tillage is concerned?
Dealing with residue. Corn residue is harder to, getting harder and harder to deal with as the companies make better varieties that have better standability, which is great for growing it. But then when we turn around in the fall or the spring after growing it, that standability means that it doesn't die off or rot down very well. So it's been increasingly harder and harder to deal with residue, especially when we're planting carrots. Residue can be a real problem for a carrot seeder. Carrot seed's very small. It can be hard to get good soil contact to the seed. So if we have any trash, it can really affect our last stand in the end, because if we don't get good coverage on it, the seed will dry out and won't germinate.
Okay, how deep would you normally till before carrots?
Before carrots in the highland, we're doing, because we farm in the highland and in marsh ground, we go about 12 inches deep in the highland, and then down on the muck, we'll ease it up to about 8 inches. So there isn't as much, you don't really get that hard pan like you can get on the highland in the marsh.
So you're looking for something to manage residue.
Yep.
Flat level surface.
Yep.
As few passes as possible.
Yes.
And at least 12 inches of depth.
Yeah, if possible, yep.
Perfect. I think we have the machine for you. It's called the Karat 10.
Excellent.
Let's go have a look.
All right, let's go.
We're just going to go a quick little overview of our Karat 10 here. It's our intensive mixing cultivator. 12 to 3 inches depth is our optimal working range on this guy. The reason that it works so well in residue is going to start up here with our front row of discs. So they're hydraulically actuated. You can pull them right up out of the ground, or you can set them nice and deep to really size that residue, those corn stalks, those potato tops that are coming through. And that you want to work into the ground. Moving on back here, we have 3 rows of shanks. So each shank is independently mounted to the frame, supported by a 550 release pressure spring. That if you max that puppy out, you've got a shear bolt here. So if you hit a real big rock, that shear bolt will break. And instead of bending and twisting the machine all up, that single shank will just be loose and flopping around. So all you have to do, lift the machine, replace the shear bolt, and away you go. One of our best features is the quick change system. So on our machine, we can change these shanks out. So if you want to get full coverage across everything, you'll use these wing shanks here. But if you want to go deeper, just do some ripping, you can put in spike shanks, or you can go shallow with our delta cut shanks. So it gives you some nice options with the quick change system. You can basically change the entire machine out within 15 minutes to half an hour. Moving on back, we have our row of star-shaped discs. So this final row of shanks will leave a bit of ridging just because of the depth that we're working at and the speeds. So the goal of these star-shaped discs is to smooth everything out before it reaches the roller. Gives the roller a nice, smooth, even playing field to work on, so it can get that really nice reconsolidation. Speaking of the rollers, this machine's set up with a 540 millimeter tube bar roller, as well as a 400 millimeter tube bar roller. So they work in tandem, just like a tandem axle would, to roll over rocks or anything like that, to make sure they have a really nice firm seed bed and all the ground gets reconsolidated. Our depth control is actually controlled by these rollers. So the weight in the machine is held up by these rollers. The depth is set hydraulically, and they hold the machine up out of the ground. So you get a really nice, firm, recompressed seed bed. where everything's nice and smooth and flat, ready to plant into. Alternatively, if you're looking to leave a rough surface for wind erosion or water erosion, things like that, if you're working in the fall, the roller can be completely removed along with the star-shaped discs, replaced with tire eradicator marks that will stop any tire marks being left in the field, and then your depth is controlled by your tires. And when you put all that together, you get the residue management system that is the LEMKEN Karat 10.
Well, we're back from the corn stalks. What did you think?
I think it did a really good job. It did a good job at cutting up the corn and mixing the residue together so that we could get a good, decent seed bed prepared to plant carrots, soybeans, whatever we wanted to plant behind it.
Perfect. I'm glad you liked it. On behalf of us, welcome to the L Team.
Perfect. Thank you.
Thank you.